International air travellers will soon be allowed to take unrestricted amounts of liquids on board again. An overhaul of Australia's airport security is coming, but some warn it will be more confusing.
It's taken 5 years, but technology is finally catching up with the terrorist.
The existing laws are very annoying, very frustrating, and of little real use in terms of aviation safety.
After successful trials of new explosive detection machines in Sydney and Melbourne, the ban on liquids above 100 mils will be scrapped from next year.
I think it'll be more flexible for travellers. It'll be a lot better.
As long as they're still tight with security and that doesn't lax off.
We want to make sure that aviation security and safety is the number one priority, but also make sure that common sense and convenience are also applied.
The clampdown began after authorities foiled a terror plot in 2006 to use liquid explosives on international flights.
In the 5 years liquid restrictions have been in place, millions of items have been seized. Every month here at Sydney Airport alone, around 8,000 items such as water bottles and cosmetics are handed over, as well as more than 1,200 duty-free liquids like alcohol and perfume.
But while Australian laws will be relaxed, some other countries can't yet afford the new screening equipment, so the restrictions will still apply.
Now, I think it'll be probably 2014 or 2015 before we have total harmonisation throughout the world.
And as advanced as the technology might be, it'll only be as good as those operating it, often low-paid, low-skilled contractors.
What should happen is the highest bidder should get the contract if we're really serious about safety.
Mazoe Ford, 10 News.